In this lecture, I want to tell you my personal approach to starting a new project, so to start to design a new website. So how do I start? The first thing I do is that I draw on paper, or in this case on an iPad, some scheme of the pages I want. For example, here maybe the general page in which I want to show to people a list of classes they may join. And then if they choose a class, they can see, for instance, a list of assignments for that particular class. Okay, so they see a list. This list, the format may depend on whether you're a student or a teacher. And then if they click on a particular assignment, okay, then they have to view some information like this or like that. Okay, so this could be a site to enable people to upload their homework. If instead I want to design a site to enable people to mark location on a map, I may want to have the initial page that looks like this. I may want here to have a big map, and here I may want to have some locations that are on the map. Okay, so each one of these may correspond to a location, and then I want to have here maybe the details of a location, and I want to have here buttons such as, I don't know, edit, add, etc., that lead each one of them to a new page. So I try to essentially sketch here a bit of the flow of the navigation, just because I want to make sure that I have some vague idea of how the pages are organized and what are the main concepts. And when I do this scheme of pages, I keep track in my mind of the various types of information that I need to have to run the site. For example, in this case, I would have to have a list of classes. Every class has some assignments. A class has some set of students, some set of teachers, maybe some set of TAs, and so on and so forth. In this case, I would have a set of locations. Every location has a title, some coordinates, some content, and then maybe I need to remember who created each location, whether it's public, whether it's shared with some users only. So drawing these pages enables me to both get a feel of the site that I need to develop and also get a feel of the data that is behind it, okay? And there are actually tools that enable you to prototype these sites to some extent, to really build some mockups. And I think those tools are very useful if you work in a large team because they enable you to create a precise specification of each page. I personally have not used them because I typically build the sites in a much smaller team. And so, for me, drawing them on paper has been enough. I never wanted to invest the time into preparing two good mockups. So this is my stage one of the design of a site, of a project. My stage two is always building the database. Build the database. And then this has two steps. So decide what? Decide the information that you want to put into it, and decide which tables you need. And then once you have it, you code it. Which in our case in Python Web means writing these models.py. Okay? In which the definition of the various tables are. So why do I want to build the database? Because once I have thought of this set of pages, I will need to build these pages one by one. And typically, in every controller, in order to build the page, I will need to get information out of the database. So I find it very difficult to write something meaningful in the controllers if I don't have at least a sketch of the database where I can get the data from in order to build the page. So once I know which pages I need, I move on to build the database because that will be the backbone on which I will build all the controllers, okay? So once the database is built, I can go and I can go to step three, which is essentially code the individual pages. Okay, which involves essentially the controller. And the controller is typically in controllers.py in if it's a small site, or else you can also divide these in multiple files, of course, right? And then I work of course on the template. And then I also work, and we will see this part later, on the JavaScript, right? If I want to build the dynamic pages with Vue. But essentially, I code each individual page. The database is already there, so I know how to write my queries in order to get the data and my data operations, and what I do is the page. And so if you work in a team, this initial aspect is quite collaborative. Right, you need to talk to each other and make these schemes and agree to them and discuss them and try to play around them in your mind to see how well they would work. Then you build the database, and again, this is a somewhat collaborative effort. Okay, so you cannot give it to someone only, or you can, but it's a fundamental step that needs to be completed. And my recommendation would be to discuss it among the whole team. Once these two steps are done, the coding of the individual pages can to some extent be broken up and given to different team members who are responsible for different pages. Okay? Now, this looks very linear, as if you do 1, 2, 3. In practice, that's how I start, is not necessarily how the site evolves. Typically, I do 1, 2, 3, then I use the site and I realize that my navigation is awkward. And so then I go back to my pages and I change them. And maybe after I change the pages in some ways, I realize that my database also needs changes to be, to contain additional information that I hadn't thought about when I designed it initially. So these pieces evolve and will co-evolve. But I find it very, very helpful each time to start in this 1, 2, 3 order, essentially. Site idea, build the database, and then you can build all the various pages on top of it.